Hi there, folks. Welcome to episode 28 of I Don't Want to Hold Your Hand, the Beatles Quarantine Catalog, where I am attempting to play all 248 Beatles songs in chronological order while this world figures itself out. As always, I am on Instagram, I am on YouTube and Venmo in case you would like to follow, subscribe, or support the series. All proceeds of this episode will go directly to the Harlem Arts Alliance. In the spirit of the Beatles, particularly John Lennon, please continue to protest, keep making the world a better place, and let's talk about the Beatles. Last episode, we talked about From Me to You, the A-side of the Beatles' next single from the early months of 1963. So naturally, it is time to talk about the B-side, which was recorded the same day as From Me to You, March 5th, 1963. Originally entitled Thank You, Little Girl, and originally intended to be the A-side of this single before it was bumped by the unexpectedly superior From Me to You, Thank You, Girl was a literal thank you to all of the teenage girls that made up the majority of the Beatles fan base. We've talked before about how early on in the Beatles catalog, most Beatles recordings are self-contained performances where they start the song, play it through, and end the song. And they do it a couple times, they pick the best take, and so the recording we know is essentially a live performance, which is very cool. We don't get that nowadays with music. This is one of the rare exceptions to that rule. Thank You, Girl is actually an edit of 6 different takes all mushed together. And that's mostly because when John recorded the harmonica parts, he was sick and couldn't get through them very well. And also, this song features Ringo's first drum solos, sort of, so a couple takes were needed to get those just right. But Thank You Girl is takes 6, 13, 17, 20, 21, and 23 mushed together, and that is the recording that we know. Things to listen for in this tune. Lyrically, this song is extremely simple. I mean, the chorus is, all I've got to do is thank you girl, that's the whole chorus. So there's not much to go off of, but there is one lyric that I absolutely love. And we've talked about these kinds of rhymes before, where the last word in each line is the same, or the last few words in this case are the same. And it's the words leading up to those words that give that payoff of a rhyme that you're looking for. So the lyric I'm talking about is on the second verse. I could tell the world a thing or two about our love. I know a little girl, only a fool would doubt our love. So our love is in both, but it's about our love, would doubt our love. I think that's genius. Good job, guys. If you deep dive into Beatles songs, which is all I seem to do with my time, you will notice patterns, you'll notice songs that sound like other songs, but one of my favorite things to discover is a song that is obviously the first draft of a better song coming up down the line. And this is one of those tunes. So, Thank You Girl sounds like this. I could tell the world a thing or two about our love. And there's a song coming up on Hard Day's Night that sounds like this. I should have known better with a girl like you. And I Should Have Known Better is, in my opinion, far superior than this song. But they come from the same place in John's brain somehow, which is just a cool thing to point out. And what would an episode of this series be if I didn't point out a mistake? There is another lyric flub in this song that is actually extremely similar to last episode and From Me to You. It seems Paul again is messing up a lyric, so apparently on March 5th, 1963, Paul was not on his game. The lyric flub I'm talking about happens on the second half of the bridge. John sings, assumably correctly, that's the kind of love that is too good to be true. And Paul sings, that's the kind of love that's just too good to be true. So John is singing is, and Paul is singing just. And you can hear it on the recording, and of course, in my cover that I'm about to do for you, I will do the same. Last thing to point out, and I don't know why this is in this song, you've probably not noticed it before. When I was a little kid, I thought stuff like this was really funny, so I would sing it, and so it really sticks out to me. But when John and Paul are singing the O's heading into the first verse and then the third verse because of the same words, they sing O, own you. They sing an N, they put an N before you. And I have no idea why they do it. They both do it, so they agreed to do it. It's there, and because it's what this series is about, I will do it in my cover as well, and you will never unhear it. Thank You Girl would not be remembered as one of the Beatles' greatest hits. In fact, John Lennon would later describe it as good practice for songwriting. John and Paul used to write songs pretty much constantly, and each one was obviously an attempt at writing their next big hit, but sometimes when the song was finished, it was just okay, and so they released it as a B-side or an album song. Thank You Girl was definitely one of those songs, but I should point out, at least it was good enough to release as a Beatles song. There is one other thing that the Beatles would do with songs that were subpar, is they could just give it to another group, which they did quite often. In fact, next episode will be our first non-Beatles Beatles song in the series, so stay tuned. Before we move on from March 5th, 1963, I do want to point out that the Beatles intended to record two other songs on this day. They would record a couple takes of one of them, and that is a tune called One After 909, which you may remember from episode 4 of this series, and more famously, you'd remember it from the album Let It Be. The other song that the Beatles hoped to record this day, they wouldn't even have time to get to it, was a new Lennon-McCartney original called What Goes On, which of course they will get to again for a little album called Rubber Soul. For more information on What Goes On, check back in like episode 120. I have no way of knowing when that's gonna be. Now please sit back and enjoy Beatles song number 28, Thank You Girl.